I'm going to show you how I did this worksheet. What I've done is I have sorted by the marks, so that could be sorting by a price or sorting by any figure, and then I've ranked the highest mark as number one and the lowest mark as the highest number. So this is how I did it. The first thing I did is I named the range marks. So the B column, I named marks. So let's just go here, and you can see that it's the marks range. And so that's where I've defined my formula. And now I have I've made this so that it works on the sheet. So when you activate the sheet, it will work. So let's enter some new character. Raccoon. Okay, and let's say 79. So that's what his mark is now. And so now let's go off the sheet and come back on the sheet. So when you come back on the sheet, you see that Rocky Raccoon has a 79. It's sorted, and he's ranked number 5 now. So let me show you how I did it. So to do it for an activated sheet, what I did is I right-clicked on the sheet, and we're going to go View Code. And what I've done is I've selected Worksheet and Activate, meaning basically if you go off the sheet and come back on the sheet, it's going to run. And the private sub now I've defined as my last row is long, and my last row is ActiveSheet.Cells.1,1 CurrentRegion.Rows.Count. And so my range is A2, because I've got header rows, to C in the last row select. And then this is Active Workbook Sheets 1 Auto Filter. This is basically all the steps for sorting your data. Basically, it's turning on the auto filter, and then it's sorting your data, and then it's turning off the auto filter by saying the statement again. Now, what I did after I've done that is I'm setting up a ranking. So range C2 select active formula equals. Now, because this is a worksheet function, I have a double equal sign here. So this is basically a formula rank average. So it's B2, and marks is my defined range, which is the B column, and it's 0. So one would be going ascending. So the lowest number would be 1, but I want the highest number, so it's 0. Okay, and then I go range to select. And then I'm going to drag this down. So I selection auto field destination range C2 to C last row. And then this is fill normal. And then we're going to, so that we can see it, we can go range C2 to C last row dot select. And then we're going to go back, in case we get to have a huge long list, we're going to go back up to the top of the list. So range C2 select. And then end sub. Enter. Now here I can, for example, I can change this around, and I can have ones that are in place, and we'll just put in a 67 for Joe Blow. And it will change the ranking, but when you go off and come back on, it has changed the order for you here too. So this is how you sort by numbers, and then put a ranking on these numbers. Please subscribe.